Hello and welcome to Fundo Money. Here we will be discussing the tax breaks, tax reductions, tax benefits that you get from a life insurance policy or life insurance plans. People might be knowing the various deductions you get, but what people tend to miss out are some of the key things that allow you, qualify you for getting tax reductions. We'll be discussing them. We'll be discussing what are the things that qualify you for getting the Section 80C benefit of up to 1.5 lakhs. We'll be talking about the benefits that you get from health elements like riders, which qualify you for tax benefits of up to 25,000 rupees annually under Section 80D. Then again, we'll be talking about some of the key things that you need to keep in mind to avail of this maturity benefits, which to make the maturity tax free, and under Section 1010D. And you will realize, as we have been arguing elsewhere in the other discussions here regarding life insurance, that the tax laws are such that they encourage you to take life insurance for protection. Life insurance for life insurance sake. Returns need to, if you're thinking of combining it with investment, that comes later. If you ignore the life insurance part, you might just be getting in trouble as far as claim tax reductions are concerned, because that is a central part of getting tax savings or tax deductions from life insurance policy. So we'll be discussing these in detail. We'll be coming back to you in just a little while. Welcome back. Welcome to Fundo Money. We are discussing the tax deductions or tax savings or tax breaks or tax benefits that you can get from life insurance policy. So let's jump into it and let's get started. Most of us would be knowing, through thanks to ads and other people telling you, that you can get up to 1.5 lakhs annually under Section 80C for the premiums you pay. But the key part is somewhere else, and that you need to keep in mind. Your life insurance amount has to be at least 10 times the premium, annual premium you pay. It could be more. The life insurance part is more. What the tax law is actually trying to ensure, that you have adequate life insurance from your life insurance plan. That's why we are saying that life insurance for life insurance sake, first protection. If you don't ensure you're getting adequately protected, then you might just not qualify for tax savings, right? So this is something that you need to keep in mind when you are buying a life insurance plan. You have to be very, very careful of products, life insurance products, which are talking about investments, single premium plans, or things that which are talking about lots of investment features. If you are planning to take a tax reduction, you better check this condition. Check with your whoever is selling it. Check the literature, brochure, etc. Make sure that you're getting this. If you're going to claim, tax reduction is not the reason why you should be buying life insurance. But if you plan to also do that, you need to check this, right? Next comes your tax deduction under Section 80D, 25,000 rupees per individual annually, and you will get it for things like riders. Life insurance rider, which can be attached to a life insurance plan, for things like surgical care riders, hospital cash riders, critical illness riders, which is great, because these once a trigger condition, qualifying condition is gets kicked off, you get that whole lump sum. So they combine very nicely with general insurance health plans, and you basically overall limit is 25,000 rupees. Per individual. So if two spouses, both the spouses are doing it, you get that kind of coverage. So that is a good variation to have, and you need to check from the product literature again whether you are qualifying for 80D benefits, because it's good to get that benefit, and because health protection is another protection that you need to have. Again, the protection has to be adequate, and that's what needs to be a focus. Focus doesn't have to be tax savings. Tax savings is a good thing to have, but your first port of call is adequate protection. Next, we come to maturity. You get tax reduction, tax benefits for maturity amount under Section 1010D. But remember, this is applicable to 2.5 lakhs of annual premium. according to the latest budget. So before it was to unlimited amounts and people were, high net worth individuals were having a great time. Now only till premiums of 2.5 lakhs. But again, the qualifying condition of 10 times annual premium also applies here. So if you didn't qualify for ATC, then you will not also qualify for 1010D. So when you are actually buying the plan, you need to be careful. So again, single premium and some of the other investment oriented products, single premium investment come life cover policies, be very, very careful whether this is getting met or not. So 10 times annual premium and up to 2.5 lakhs annual premium, these have become the qualifying condition. Now, if it's there's a return of premium that is tax free if these conditions are met. If you're exiting it earlier before maturity, you're exiting, but you've completed 10 years, there's a very good chance that you'll be, and you've been paying your premiums regularly, there's a very good chance that you're qualifying for the whole amount being tax free on maturity. In any case, if you are exiting it before time, then there are other conditions that apply depending on the products. We are providing links in the description section. You can check them out. For premature surrender, these are some of the issues. Suppose it is taxable, TDS gets deducted. If the company has got your PAN number, the deduction is less. If they don't have your PAN details by some stroke of bad luck, then more amount gets deducted. So it's good to have for them to have these details for you. But again, as we have mentioned to you, that tax laws actually encourage you to have adequate life insurance. And actually, because that makes sense, you need to protect yourself first and then look at investment and returns. So keep all these things in mind when you are buying a life insurance policy. The first focus has to be on protection. Then if you get tax benefits, that's fine. You get benefits in any case for provident fund contribution. You get it for home loan principal repayment. We're talking about section 80C and children's tuition fees. So you need not be too hung up on tax deductions for premium contribution. So there's only limited amount available, that's 1.5 lakhs. So you can take it easy and focus entirely on your protection. And if you get a tax deduction, that's a bonus. So we hope you found this useful. If you liked it, share it with others, hit the like button and get connected with us on all leading social media networks. Till the next time, take very good care of yourself and goodbye.